We are about to witness one of the greatest events in human history. The world as we know it is crumbling before our very eyes, and the majority of the world population is not aware of it. Power structures that have been in place for thousands of years are taken down as we speak. Soon we'll be shown evidence of an elite plan so evil, so all-encompassing, that people will be shocked to the core. This documentary was made to help you deal with what's coming. Is it a good thing? Oh yes, it's the best thing that could possibly happen to us. But in order to understand and process the quantum leap that we as humanity are about to take, you must understand the reality, the timeline if you wish, that we as a species were placed in. And believe me, you don't have a clue just yet. The evil I mentioned has been working behind the scenes so intelligently, so brilliantly, that hardly anyone ever noticed a thing. What I'm going to do is first of all give you a short overview of things that made me go, Things that made me decide to start digging for the truth. We'll take it from there, shall we? Are you ready? Join me on a journey down the rabbit hole. Let's start with the recent forest fires, for instance in California. Did you know that these fires forgot to burn trees? That they were capable of cutting through houses? That they burn trees from the inside out? That they were able to lift cars, tilt them, and smash them down? Are you sure these are ordinary forest fires? And how about this one? We live in a world where mercury is considered highly toxic, but not when we inject it into children in absurd quantities. No doubt you've heard about chemtrails. Denied by our governments for a long time, but recently acknowledged and referred to as geoengineering aerosols. They are sprayed into our atmosphere to protect us from global warming. The thing that makes me go however, is the fact that we're sprayed with heavy metals, which are stored in our brains, where they have proven to cause Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. And did you know that in many countries, among which my own Holland, we have to explicitly say no to organ donation, for if we don't, our organs will be property of the state as soon as we are declared brain dead? The last time it was arranged this way by law was during the Nazi occupation. Did you know that our current Pope is the first to state that hell does not exist, but the devil does? Isn't it weird that the Vatican's audience hall is full of references to reptilians? Snakes? Serpents? Did you know the Vatican's telescope is called Lucifer? And since when does the Pope make the sign of the devil? Whereas one bird can cause terrible damage to a plane, on 9/11, two planes managed to cut through steel. A third plane mysteriously disappeared in a building, and number four plunged into the earth without leaving any debris or bodies. The planes were piloted by terrorists who only had had a few flying lessons in a small Cessna. Then there are the horrid attacks on innocent people, in which the same victims can survive up to three different attacks. This lucky young man survived being shot in the head. All he needed was a band-aid. And thank God not all victims are people of flesh and blood. What do you think about this one? Are you a parent? Are you aware of the fact that children cartoons contain subliminal messages of sex and violence? Why? Did you know that fully grown fetuses can be legally aborted in many American states? That advocates of full-term abortion state that unborn babies cannot feel pain? Whereas every doctor knows that the nervous system is the first to develop in fetuses? Is abortion of a fully grown baby not the same as murder? Okay, let's have a look at the migrant caravan. Thousands of people fled their South American homes to look for a better future in the US. The trip covered 2,000 miles in 1.5 months in order to be on time for the American midterm elections as a political statement against President Trump. This means they walked an average of 45 miles a day on flip-flops. Barefoot, like this, and like this, 45 miles a day? Why do Hollywood celebrities promote the use of facial creams containing the foreskin of baby boys? Do you realize that these foreskins are actually sold? That it's a trade? What's next? Drinking baby blood? Now, I'm going to give you 5 more, although I could go on forever. Counting down, number 5. Did you know that diseases such as AIDS, Zika, SARS, and Ebola are actually patented? Do you know when something is patented? When it's man-made. Man-made diseases, are you kidding me? Number 4. Your cell phone, laptop, tablet, and your TV contain spyware that works 24/7, no matter whether your device is switched on or off. This means you are constantly being monitored. Each and every conversation, whether at home or at work, is recorded. Why? And by whom? Number 3. In 2018, Monsanto, known for its genetically modified seeds and crops, plus its poisonous weed killer Roundup, was bought by Bayer, a chemical giant that produces mostly poison. In other words, our food supply is now largely controlled by the producers of carcinogenic poison. Monsanto started off producing Agent Orange, a very powerful and highly toxic chemical used during the Vietnam War to eliminate forest cover and to destroy crops. But it turned out to do just a little bit more than that, causing horrific birth deformities and various types of cancer. According to experts, the fusion of Monsanto and Bayer was the perfect match made in hell. Number 2. In 2018, Hillary Clinton admitted that she deleted 33,000 emails from a private server used as Secretary of State. Not only that, she used a hammer to smash her cell phones, SIM cards, and hard drives. Any further evidence that could have been used against her in a court of law was destroyed by fire that conveniently started in the office of a mansion. Did she actually get away with that? And last but not least, number 1. President Obama received the 2009 Nobel Peace Prize only months after his inauguration. Why, for God's sake? He came from nowhere and had achieved nothing at the time. In the following 8 years, he invaded 7 countries and dropped a bomb every 20 minutes. Who on earth was on that Nobel committee? The world is not what you think. And guess what all of these things have in common? They were completely ignored by the mainstream media. Not one news channel covered or questioned any of it. And just when I thought I'd seen it all, this became President of the US. I always thought there were two political sides in life, left and right. Left was for the common people, right was for the rich. But I soon found out that my ideas did not reflect reality at all. Obama seemed to have enchanted everybody, including myself, with his good looks and charms. But like I said, he invaded 7 countries. He was a Democrat, for God's sake. And Democrat Bill Clinton went from one sex scandal to the next, lying under oath and getting away with it. Maybe left and right were simply two wings of the same bird? In spite of my leftist upbringing and background and my fierce opposition against Trump, I decided to give him the benefit of the doubt. But how did he get elected in the first place? Just before the elections, WikiLeaks arose. Founded by Julian Assange in 2006, WikiLeaks is a giant online library of the world's most censored documents, obtained by whistleblowers at the highest level. Much information deals with war, spying, and corruption. Now, just before the presidential elections, WikiLeaks published highly incriminating evidence of the corruption within the Clinton Foundation and the Clinton presidential campaign. So, what happened? That happened. On January 20, 2017, Donald J. Trump was inaugurated as President of the United States of America. But how did WikiLeaks obtain the evidence of the Clinton corruption? It was leaked by an employee of the Democratic National Committee, Seth Rich, who was subsequently found dead with 2 bullets in his back. Who killed Seth Rich? We will find out in the next episodes. What do we have for now? Donald Trump as President of the US. And then, out of nowhere, arose the enigma of Q.